Hello everyone and welcome to the next series in the Intel Extreme Masters Season 2 group stage. We are again going to finish Group C, this time with the match between the two Swedes. In this group is DowaQ on the top right spawn position here of Turtle Rock in red with his main race undead. Of course, he starts with the Altar Crypt and the Ziggurat here with the four Acolytes, so the build we've seen the most so far in Undead versus Nightlife matchups. And his opponent, yeah, also from Sweden, the Nightlife player in yellow on the top left spawn position. It is LiiLD.C, so it's going to be close positions here on Turtle Rock, certainly not going to bother DowaQ all too much. LiiLD.C, on the other hand, definitely not going to be overly excited about that, and we are currently looking at the only two players in Group C who haven't been able to win a best of three so far. Then again, both of them have only played one best of three so far, with DowaQ losing against Fire and LiiLD.C losing against Grubby. So one of these two players after this series is already going to find himself in a pretty tough spot. Scout is now coming in by the undead, and he's gonna see that it is close spawn positions. And I think especially if DowaQ loses here, it's going to be, I wouldn't say deadly, but extremely painful for him already, as he is the one of these two players who still has to face both Todd and Grubby, whereas LiiLD.C, if he loses, at least he has faced Grubby already, and he's only got one of the, you know, very big dogs to face, left to face in the group stage. So second ghoul is already coming in, and I think he's going to be easily able to get the cancel on the second Moonwell here, which is already quite terrible for LiiLD.C, who is not going to be able to get his hero out as long as the second Moonwell hasn't finished. He's at 16 out of 20 supply, and maybe he's going to be forced to detonate a Wisp here because, yeah, he's got no supply to get his hero, and he's going to need that. DK is spawning right now, heading across the map. The Wisp is heading towards the tavern right now. Oh, yeah, he's at 15 out of 20 right now, so it looks like he detonated a Wisp there. First Ghoul is being sent back. The Death Knight, unlike some other undeads we've seen so far in this tournament, is not selling his TP early on to get the additional gold to be just able to apply a little bit more pressure while still taking somewhat quickly. Detonator is coming in nicely just in time, so no XP for the Death Knight yet, but still another Wisp already down is not great use. Coil is being dodgy with the first Wisp, but not with the second one. So first XP is going to the Death Knight, and this Archer is in trouble as well, as the Moonwell has not quite finished yet. Now finally second Moonwell is up for LiiLD.C, but he already has lost two Wisps to Detonates here, one to a Coil and an Archer, so not at all the opening he was hoping for here. The first Ghoul is in some trouble as well. Death Knight is coming in. He doesn't have any more mana to Coil though, so that one might still be in trouble unless the Death Knight is able to pull off a nice block here. The Quilby still has half its duration available, though the Beastmaster not able to squeeze past this Death Knight. The Quilby is coming in though, and he only needs one more hit. And the Death Knight switching the block right now to the Quirbeast. The Nerubian Tower is coming just now. That seems to be a little bit too late. The second Quirbeast has been spawned here. The Ghoul 2, who is actually pretty low HP, is pulling very far back into the base here. The Quirbeasts are charging forward. Are they going to fight the Ghoul here? It looks like, yes, they are. But what is... Ah, he's not going for it. He saw it. So a bit of a mistake. Quite a mistake there by LiiLD.C, actually, who's... Beastmaster and Archer should be able to get this camp without all too much trouble here. The Quirbeast now, as the tower has finished, is going to be taken down extremely easily. First creep has gone to the Beastmaster here, as it seems. So has the second one and the third one. Death Knight does have mana again. He's now at 70 HP, can coil him down, but the coil is coming in too late. No more mana for the Death Knight, and he is quite low already. Only like 3 more hits remaining, perhaps, until he's going down. So he's really risking it here. 28 HP, is trying to run away. The Archer's turning around, but just for a brief moment, the Beastmaster doesn't get surrounded here against the Forest. The Death Knight should be quick enough to get away from this Beastmaster. The Archer here is being pulled back in time. DK survives. Tech is going to start just now for the Night Elf. DowaQ is already quite a bit ahead tech-wise. Looks like LiiLD.C wants to play it extremely safe here, getting the fourth mover before starting his tech here already. I mean, he has suffered quite a bit in the beginning economically, so he had to rebuild a lot of wisps, which cost him quite a bit. And in addition, with the very safe tech choice after four movers, you know, that's just what it leads to timing wise. Both of them continue creeping a little bit. Beastmaster is gonna get level 2 here. He found close of attack, he found the mantle on his green camp. DK found Belt of Giant Strength on his green camp. And is he actually gonna go ahead and creep his natural right away? I mean, the two giant sea turtles are gonna down quite easily, but the gargantuan sea turtle is going to put up quite a bit of resistance here, but more goose are being pulled. Dovak is losing one here to the creeps. He cannot bring his DK in because the turtle is gonna switch to low HP units as soon as they come in range. Hawk of the Night Elf scouts the undead creeping here, and he's going for the creep check, which is going to be definitely too late. And I think Dova can just fall back quite easily here. He gets a greater heal potion. Perfect item for him. Let's see if he's going to be forced to use it immediately. The answer is yes, he is. And that's at least a little bit of a success for LiiLD.C. But a huge load of XP did just go to this DK. He lost one ghoul in return, but definitely worth it. Second crypt and graveyard finished already. Tier 2 is about to finish, so we're gonna see gargoyle production starting immediately here as tier 2 is finishing. The hawk continues tracking the undead army, sees that it's coming in again, doesn't have all too much here if LiiLD.C micros properly with this number of archers and the quill beasts. It's going to be difficult for Dovak to achieve anything at the moment, but just preventing LiiLD.C from getting anything done is already, you know, enough of a success for Dovak for the time being. He's getting the Lich extremely quickly here, so it looks like this might turn out to be a bit of a timing attack here, not the Hasu Ops like super long drawn out harassment game, but staying on tier 2 for a bit, getting a couple of gargoyles, getting the Lich super quickly here. So it looks like he is gonna wanna be able to fight soon-ish here. And the Nova against the archers is of course basically integral part of the proper undead composition. One lore is coming thus far, a lot of wisps moving across the base here. Looks like he is anticipating some gargoyle harassment soon. One wisp here, sees the ghouls heading. Where are they heading exactly? Home seems to be the answer for now. Three gargoyles already out, and the lore is going to be cancelled, which is all due to the early game here, basically. If the Night Death tech had been quicker, then there would be no way in hell that with only the heroes and three gargoyles, Dovak could do nearly as much damage already. And the panda is not getting called here. He's calling the archers. It looks like he didn't see the panda. Panda gets staffed though. And yeah, now with only the two heroes and a lot of necromancy, look at how much damage Dovak is able to do. This is terrible for LiiLD.C, investing so much into these archers and basically losing so many of them for free. I think a town portal would have definitely been necessary here. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 archers, I think, have fallen here. And LiiLD.C didn't really kill anything in return. Another archer is being staffed here. The next one is falling. One archer is left standing here in this fight. And LiiLD.C didn't kill anything here. This is terrible. 44 supply against 26. Death Knight, 3.5. Lich is already, you know, somewhat close to level 2 without having crept anything. And speaking of creeping anything, with all of these archers lost, it's going to be extremely difficult for LiiLD.C to level up his heroes properly. One Ancient of Lore has finally finished in the meantime, second one is coming, couple of archers still in the main, and yeah, there's, with the aura, there's not really any danger of anything dying here from Dovak. The Lich is coming back in. He's got one more Nova to work with, and there's gonna have to be the town portal he used, and he's using it just as the DK is raising his arm for the coil, so at least not losing a hero here. Psst. And the undead is trying to keep up the pressure immediately. The Beastmaster needs to get to a mover here, which he's doing in time. Archer is being coiled and staffed, so no kill there for Dovak. And this choice of the early Lich of the delayed tier 3 tech, which by now is halfway done, has definitely paid out for the undead player. Now he starts harassing a couple of wisps. First one is being saved for the time being. Moolah has to be cancelled. Lumber wise, it's looking... well, for the moment it's looking okay, but LiiLD.C is not gonna really have the resources to either add an ancient protector or go tier 3 or anything like that, so he's gonna be stuck, at least it looks like it, with what he's got at the moment, which is going to be Beastmaster, Panda, and a lot of Dryads. 40 supply in the meantime against 50. DowaQ adding a slaughterhouse, soon to reach tier 3. The Ancient of War here uprooted for some reason, perhaps wanted to go ahead and help him creep somewhere. That didn't work out for now, and the Death Knight is coming in, and he's probably going to be able to get the last hit here with a coil. Yes, he is. Item goes to LiiLD.C, which is the big heal potion, but I mean, wow, and he's even getting the last hit with the Death Knight here. No XP for the Night Elf thus far from this camp. Is he gonna get this one as well? No. Level 2 finally on the Panda, but yeah, that one is extremely underleveled for this stage of the game where there's already so many gargoyles up in the air. One of them is being picked off right now. The Death Knight and Lich being pretty much out of mana here is making it hard for DowaQ to continue applying pressure for the moment. The Nova, the last Nova, kills another archer, but the slaughterhouse is finished, and as soon as he wants to, well, he needs to, or he's gonna produce more cigarettes in soon, I imagine. And once he's doing so, he can add statues, and that's gonna help him a great deal with keeping up his mana, keeping some regeneration going. And especially with the lack of a Demon Hunter, he's gonna have a great time using his Coil Nova against basically the heroes only, probably, of the Night Elf, because he's only relying on gargoyles here. He continues creeping, by the way. Panda is still not really all too close to level 3. He finds an energy pendant though, which is going to help him a great deal. One zero upgrades on the gargoyles, no upgrades here. Hunter's Hall is producing the 1-0 attack upgrade though for the Dryads. Abolished Magic now, researched. And the Lich is being crept up here as well. Solo creeping that one, wants to have level 2 Nova. Of course, heal scroll wise, he's got one at the moment. Maybe gonna get a second one right now as he's at the shop. Ah, and he was trying to go for a greedy expansion here, but cancelled quite quickly. Actually, I think with a second heal scroll, where's the Undead Army? He's got a second heal scroll right now. I think he can fight with two heal scrolls against a level 2 Panda. That should definitely be a fight worth taking. First Drunken Haze, Breath of Fire is coming in. Panda gets nuked immediately. He has to use the small heal potion which he had on that hero. Staff is on the Beastmaster, and he's gonna have to use it. There's no town port on the Beastmaster, and now he can just start shift attacking through those Dryads, and that's exactly what he's doing. The first one has fallen. The first gargoyle is, or the first gargoyles have fallen already though as well. DK is already out of mana. He's got one more heal scroll left on the Lich. Nova has gone onto the Beastmaster. Next Breath of Fire coming in by the Panda, who's bought another heal potion. Used that one already, level 3 right now on him. But all of the Dryads have already fallen, and there's basically only the two heroes remaining, and they are not gonna do it against still a 40 supply undead army. 2-0 upgrades on the gargoyles, 31 supply remaining for LiiLD.C, who has at least reached the level 3 here, but still, this, I mean, only heroes is not enough against a still decently sized undead army. Gargoyles here forced another detonate, if we heard that correctly, and now still staying at under 50 supply. Statue production starts for DowaQ as well. He has, you know, been given a little bit of free supply to work with again after that fight. Still traded very much favorably for him, and with two Dryads and two heroes, the Night Elf player is gonna go ahead and creep the red camp right now. He needs to risk something. He needs to come back somehow into this game. And it looks like taking the biggest camp on the map with quite a small army is the way he's gonna go here. And perhaps he's gonna be rewarded. DowaQ is just for the moment creeping the middle here. First statue has arrived. Second statue... does he have two already? Does he only have one? It looks like he only has one. And getting the Destroyer upgrade here immediately. I mean, Destroyers, well, Cloak of Shadows, Cloak of Flames isn't gonna do it here for LiiLD.C. I guess an item worth selling. There's like one ghoul left in the undead army, so yeah, immolation is really not gonna do anything here. First gargoyle gets taken out, coil is being used way too late, and panda has used breath of fire here. The statue with the heal is going to help a great deal, and there's still only so few dryads on the ground that it's super easy for the undead to snipe them out one by one. The death knight does have mana for coil again and uses that one right now. Lich is back to full HP. The panda is in trouble once again. Does the staff have cooldown? I'm not so sure. The panda is running away and he's getting to the shop. Gargoyle's coming back. He decides to just safely take the kills on those dryads. I mean, look at how quickly they are going down. Panda with an invul potion here. Just use that to get in range of the Beastmaster to use the staff, which is quite a bit of a waste here, to be honest. And after this fight, after this creep camp has been cleared out, things have not gotten any better for LiiLD.C. DowaQ still at 47 supply, still not breaking, still no need to break. He is, as far as I can see, not going for a new expansion attempt. But with the Lich level 4 already, with the DK closing in on level 5 already, the nuke isn't gonna get any worse for DowaQ. As we can see, compared to the undead heroes, the Night Elf quite a bit behind in everything. Upgrades, army, heroes. No heal scrolls remaining for DowaQ though, so maybe he's gonna wanna quickly stop at the shop and pick up at least one new heal scroll. But for now, he's just falling back. He knows that there's no point in fighting, and he's picking up even both of them. So yeah, now he seems to be ready to fight again. Mana-wise, he's not looking all too great on his heroes. He's found the wand of mana stealing though, so at least a little bit of mana is going to be available for coils. And where are the gargoyles heading? Oh, down here, they're going to find two more wisps. Yes, they are. These are doomed. No way in hell for LiiLD.C to keep those alive. LiiLD.C though does have a lot of lumber. He's relying solely on the dryads, not going for tier 3, not going for anything else. Hawk got sniped out here. The dryads are catching the ground army of the undead in quite a tricky position though. One statue is going to be picked off. He's trying to go for the surround on the second one. Doesn't get it. In the meantime, the gargoyles are going to head into the main base though. Detonate is being used in time. LiiLD.C, yeah, not microing all too horrible for the most part, but still, it doesn't seem like he's even close to challenging DowaQ here. Who's just gonna go ahead and go for the Entangled Goldmine here. A couple of Dryads are coming in, but without the hero support, it's pretty difficult for him to really deal with this harassment at the moment. Where are the Night Elf heroes? Still in the middle, chasing this ground army. And he's got one statue killed, but that was so worth it for DowaQ, who's got a bunch of wisps killed in return. Now one of the gargoyles is falling. Panda has been staffed back. Gargoyles are retreating. And DowaQ, yeah, somehow he's at under 50 still, and he didn't save up all too much gold. He still didn't add those additional cigarettes. Looks like he has, okay, now he's adding one. Was just about to say, looks like he still has no intention of breaking into low upkeep anytime soon. The mains are about to run out though. And if, let me just quickly, okay, still no expansion attempt by DowaQ. And if LiiLD.C stays alive here and somehow gets his Tree of Ages up to his natural expansion, DowaQ could still find himself in trouble eventually. Excuse me. Continuing to do some harassment. Panda did get the Drunken Haze in. No Breath of Fire though. And first Abomination added. Disease Cloud added. 60 Supply Cigarette is soon to finish. Gargoyles continue harassing. One more Wisp gets picked off. The panda, wow, what is he doing? Well, the gargoyles are sort of low, or have taken a bit of damage, so I imagine the breath was probably on cooldown. Yeah, Abomination and the two heroes coming in here, gonna force the heal potion out of this Beastmaster, which he's using right now. In return, the Abomination is falling though, and the Lich has to fall back. Death Knight has one more coil remaining and a mana potion though, so plenty of coils. Dryad and the Cool Beast are going for a bit of blocking. Damage output isn't really all too great by LiiLD.C. And is the Lich able to squeeze out of there? Yeah, still the greater heal potion also available on the Lich, but LiiLD.C is really giving it his all. Breath of Fire going in, Drunken Haze afterwards. And now it might be up to the DK to do some blocking. He also does have a town portal. Maybe he could just pass it. One of mana stealing used here for another coil onto that Lich. But I think probably compared to just using the town portal, Dovak definitely prefers wasting more of LiiLD.C's time here while he continues harassing with the gargoyles, which is exactly what he's doing right now. And yeah, he was able to shake off this Night Elf army, the panda, step back once again. Breath of Fire, if I saw it correctly, dodged here by the gargoyles who are up in the air again and flying away. Oops. 3-0 upgrades, by the way. In the meantime, mains are gonna run out in half a minute though. Dovak has saved up a lot of resources by now, so I imagine he's gonna wanna go ahead, wait for the mine to run out, and then produce as much of an army as he can. And if somehow LiiLD.C can transfer his Tree of Ages to the natural, I think he still has a shot of winning the game. It's all Dreadlord third by Dovak. It's all going to come down to whether or not LiiLD.C is going to be able to establish a new source of gold income once this one runs out. But that is a tough challenge. There are two heal scrolls currently on the undead heroes. Looks like LiiLD.C is gonna want to go ahead and get away with a bit of creeping. Perhaps the red camp, which he sees right now with the hawk, has not been taken yet. Another abomination being produced, another hero being produced here. No more gargoyles currently. He's adding fiends. Alright. Not going to be all too bad against the dryads, I imagine. Rather unconventional to see fiends together with gargoyles used by the undead here. It's all going to come down to whether or not he's going to be able to prevent the night elf from expanding here. Don't think he's gonna want to go for his own expansion. Robe of the Magi for the Beastmaster. Let's see, is it going to be a Tome of Experience? No. And therefore, he doesn't reach level 5 here. Would have been quite helpful to have the level 3 Quill Beasts available. And it looks like Dovak is ready to push right now. He's down to 280 gold, 66 supply against 50 still. Now, LiiLD.C is breaking as well. Perhaps slightly too late, as the giant army of his opponent is coming in and taking down the first Moonwell already. The second Moonwell is going to fall as well. He's already supply blocked. He's only going to get out these two Dryads. And how the hell is he supposed to win that fight, even with his base support? The Beastmaster here in the middle is only buying a town point. No other items. He's kept the Cloak of Flames, strangely enough. And yeah, now there's the two heroes, a bunch of Dryads against the full undead army here. DK is quite far up front, but he's looking extremely tanky against the mostly piercing damage that LiiLD.C has available. Sleep goes on the panda here. The gargoyles haven't really taken all too much damage thus far. There's still two heal scrolls available for the undead player. Death Knight is now going to have to be a little bit careful, but all of the dryads are being picked off here by all of the piercing damage one by one, and the Beastmaster is being taken down as well. 31 supply remaining for LiiLD.C, and the panda is going to fall next. No way that LiiLD.C can stay in this game any longer. He's leaving after 23 minutes in a game where he was behind basically right from the start. Basically after his first Moonwell got, or second Moonwell got cancelled, he lost three Wisps and the one of the archers. Therefore his tech was delayed by a lot. His Angels of Lore were delayed afterwards because Dovak had the Lich out already and Gargoyles out already to just march into the Night Death base and yeah, cancel the lore. And on top of that, he lost like six archers when he grabbed his Goblin Merchant. And by that point, the game was like, I don't know, 7-8 minutes in, and LiiLD.C was already at a huge disadvantage. So yeah, he played an uphill battle from there. He was never able to get anywhere close to equalizing, basically. And Dovak took his time, mined out his entire gold, and then went for the big push with a way superior army, superior heroes, better items, better upgrades, better everything, and wins the first map quite clearly here. And interestingly, since the undead won the first map here, we're gonna see Twisted Meadows as map number 2. So that's gonna be an interesting challenge for LiiLD.C to tie the series on that map against an undead who is most likely gonna go ahead and play Gargoyles again, and of course who's going to do his best to make use of the map to its fullest. So yeah, that's what we're gonna see next.